The metrosexual movement of the 2000s was an era where grown men began to favor things like really tightly fitting jeans and a stronger focus on things like grooming and personal care. This is one of the things that led to the hipster movement of the 2010s. Oddly enough, in 2024, nowadays, looking back, we would just call these people... Welcome, traders, to the Indicator Profile series for this Wednesday. We have the Metro Indicator, which was also created right around the same time as the metrosexual movement, which made me think about it. Now, the important thing we all want to know is the Metro Indicator viable for our systems? Is it a viable indicator in general? We're going to find out. But first, if you're new, understand, you have reached the number one indicator channel in all of YouTube. It's always been that way. It will always be that way. But you're not going to understand what we're talking about. So instead of asking silly questions in the comments section, which I'm not going to answer, go here instead. Go to nononsenseforex.com. Read that first page. Watch the video on that page. And get yourself started. Get yourself caught up. It's worth it. Now for the rest of you who are caught up, let's go over the specs on the Metro Indicator of the year, like I said, 2005. It's a bit of an older indicator, yes, but it is still within the 1996 and on threshold we like to see here. The type is going to be a confirmation indicator. Subtype will be a two lines cross. Now it's going to be a little bit different looking than your standard two lines cross, which we really like. I love when we're able to show indicators that look a little bit different on the Indicator Profile series. And this one's going to be a bit unique. Now, as far as an exit goes, for that reason, two lines cross indicators do lend themselves as good exit indicators normally, but the way this one's set up, it's really hard to tell. I think the potential is there, but I have not had time to test it myself, and this is not an indicator I was familiar with in the past. You know, this one's brand new to me too. So test it, but understand that I do think there is potential there. So let's go ahead and take a look at it. In its original form, it looks a little something like this. So it's going to be a bit on the messy side. This orange line here is actually an RSI. Now, we have said in the past, too, some of your best indicators of all time are nothing more than derivatives and improvements of classic indicators like the RSI, for example. But for this particular purpose, we found it better to just take it off altogether. Much cleaner, much easier to read, and much better performing if you just simply do that one thing. So what we have now is a situation where if you see the blue line cross and close above, like right here, I think it pretty much landed on the line. You don't want that. You want where it crossed and closed above the magenta line, and that will be your signal to go long. And then vice versa, as soon as it's gotten beyond the magenta line to the downside right here, that will be your signal to go short. Now, I am kind of glad we see this right here, because that's going to be a situation that might be a bit confusing to people who are not used to this, but I would say look up here at your numbers. And if these numbers are the same for some reason, because it really looks like that on the indicator, then that would not be a signal. But if you look up here and the value for the blue line is more than the magenta line, then that would be a signal, even though aesthetically it might be really hard to see. So that's going to have to be your call. You're going to have to do a little bit of fine tuning in these rare situations where the blue line kind of sits on the magenta line. Now, in the blog, which I know a lot of you go straight to the blog after this, you're going to see a little phenomenon that Dan describes to where when markets really start to trend, there becomes a separation between, or a greater separation between, the blue line and the magenta. And then when it kind of stalls out a little bit, things get pretty flat. Things are often flat with the magenta line, but then even the blue line starts to flatten out. I would really caution against giving that any merit whatsoever. It might be true, it might be interesting, but unless you can really find a use for something like that, I would do your absolute best to ignore it altogether. I think it's just going to throw you off. It's kind of like how Bollinger Bands expand and contract. I don't think there's a lot of use there for an actual trader. I think it's just more of an interesting thing to look at in hindsight. So appreciate it for its novelty and the fact that it's interesting, but don't let it distract you from the one thing it is here to do, and that is to give you a signal, because the results you are about to see are strictly based on those buy and sell signals. Got it? So let's go ahead and take a look at those. Before we do, understand, it doesn't matter what you're about to see here. I mean, we're not going to show you indicators that underperform, but you have to test this yourself. That is literally all that matters. Full stop. Now, if you don't know how to do that, we got you covered amongst many things in the description in the links below. One of those links is a link to my automation blog that has an embedded video from Dan Stone himself showing you how to test this yourself on the MT4 strategy tester. You also get a link to the blog, like I said, if you want to see the tweak settings, which we don't reveal here, and all of the cool stuff that this indicator brings to the table. The blog is where to do that. You can also go to Dan's YouTube channel. We'll link that as well. He always has a corresponding video to my video where he will show you this indicator moving in real time to show you it doesn't repaint, and other tidbits and informations that I might not share here. You can also have a link to submit your own indicator for profiling. Most of them don't make it, but the ones that have made it have been very good, and they have come from you, and we really appreciate that. So even if you don't know how well it's going to perform, or if we're going to like it or not, or if it's going to make the show, send it anyway, but do it here. And then the number one place, it just overtook Google itself in all of the interwebs. It is the link to the indicator library, where you can download the Metro indicator and every indicator we have done here on the Indicator Profile Series. Let's go ahead and take a look at the results. Check out the Euro USD, and things are starting to get good again. 8.5% return on investment on your USD is, it's starting to become a bit more normal, but you guys remember when 5% was good. It's 8% now with a very nice win-loss ratio with a healthy amount of trades, but not too many. I personally like 22. Some people are going to favor a bit more, but I would be quite excited if I saw these numbers myself as a Forex trader. Now, the one thing you should get really excited about, depending on who you are, is, oh my God, we finally get a W for the 4-hour traders, and a big one, 13.5% on a Forex pair. Tremendous. Enjoy your W, 4-hour traders. I'm very happy to see this, but just know also that it is going to be temporary as we move on into gold. So gold is getting really good too. Although this here, I would say, is probably average for what we've been seeing in the past few weeks. About 35% return on interest on gold. A little higher win-loss ratio than we've been seeing, though. With gold, you almost have to eat a lower win-loss ratio in order to get these higher returns. But 50-50 on this with 30 trades. That's better than we've seen. Now, taking it over to the S&P indices traders, you've got to like this. People who are new to the Indicator Profile Series are going to see this and think it's not a big deal. If you're an indices trader, you know this is a big deal. You know, closing in on 10% with one indicator, you know, like we would see that in the early days of the Indicator Profile Series, but we have not seen it for a while. And even if you're a 4-hour indices trader, you are getting some really nice returns here. We've been talking on my investing podcast, The 10-Minute Contrarian, about using the monthly chart to fine-tune in on the best times to enter and exit the market overall. And for people interested in doing that, pay very close attention to what you see on the Indicator Profile Series on the S&P 500. I know we're doing daily with this, but we currently don't have any other way to measure this on the monthly chart. So, all things considered, take what works really good on the daily and see how it works on the monthly. Finishing it off with Bitcoin, and this is about par for the course from what we've been seeing, right around 30% return on investment in the last, I don't know, maybe 3 or 4 episodes. So there's not much to write home about here, although it's certainly not bad. And we hope you have enjoyed this installment of the Indicator Profile Series. Like, subscribe, hit the bell. We have so many things going on here. We have the Trading Psychology podcast every other week. This has been the one thing that so many traders have come to me and said, this was the thing that I needed to really put me over the hump. People who listen to the Trading Psychology podcast simply do better than people who don't. I have no proof on that, but I can reasonably assume this. And don't forget, Indicator Profile series every other week as well. There's a blog, which is a full database of great alpha and great information for you. And then the 10-Minute Contrarian Investing podcast, like I just said, every Saturday. How could you not subscribe to this channel? And how could you not wake up every day and go get it?